Welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. We are live right here on Facebook, YouTube. We should be live across the gamut here on Periscope, Twitch, and on Facebook if I didn't already say Facebook. So let us get rolling on the Facebook side. Then we should be good to go. So if you're on Facebook, let me know if you can see the visuals, because on my screen, it doesn't show me the visuals for some reason. So I would love to hear if you can see the screen. So what's going on? Kelvin's here. Roman's here, or Ramen. Forgive me if I'm saying that wrong. Let me reconnect the Facebook stream. So those on Facebook, just let me know if you can see the screen and then we can get started rolling out. So I'll say what's up to everybody who just joined. We got Ramen here. We got Los Nikos. We got Joe Kings here from Periscope. Captain Dirty Beard's back. We got Vinny. We got Sakul. Lawrence is in here. This little homie, what's going on? Young Ziff, welcome. Koopa, what's going on? Oh, you know what I forgot to do? I need to share this stream on my personal page quickly before I forget. Koopa, what's up? Ion, what's going on? Dez, Akram, FM Radio's here. I'm Joe King is here. I think I just announced that again, but welcome back for the third time, Captain Dirty Beard. What's going on? Let's see. Who'd I miss? Trillist, welcome. So I'm missing a lot of comments, and forgive me, but I just want to make sure. Big A's here. What's up? Just want to make sure Facebook can see the stream. So let me know on Facebook. If just give me a quick FB so we can get started and we don't have any issues for future stuff. All right. So let me share this quickly on my personal page and then we'll get rolling. Thank you, Michael, for writing in. I do appreciate that. It helps me know that can you see the screen? Let me know if you can see the screen. All right, so give me 2 seconds and we will get rolling. So today we're going to create a hip hop track using Nexus. I'm going to use the sounds you want to use, or at least show you what's in the libraries. The libraries I like to use, and just a quicker way to use Nexus and a different way to use Nexus. So not just the typical, you know, standard presets. I'm going to show you how to make it sound a lot more unique. And a lot of people don't even realize you can do a lot of stuff in Nexus. So we're going to break that down since it's a very popular plugin. Okay, and don't forget there's a free sweepstakes at BusyWorksBeats.com/contest where you can enter to win your favorite plugin. So you could win Nexus, for example. What's up, Cinco? Facebook available on MacBook? Oh, FL Studio. I don't know why I read that Facebook. Okay, let me just triple check to make sure Facebook can see the screen. Okay, cool. What's going on? All right, we're good to go. So if you can help your fellow producers out and just, you know, answer some questions if I'm missing them, that would be awesome. So let's continue the live stream. We got 240 folks ready to go. So let's focus in on Nexus. Now, Nexus is, we call it a rompler. Think of it like, let me load it up quickly. It might take a little bit to load, but before I load it up, think of it like a keyboard that has expansion discs that you can put inside the keyboard and load up sounds. So think of it like an Xbox. Okay, Nexus is Xbox. And the expansions are the video games. And you can change out your video games as you like. So think of it that way. You don't necessarily need a video game to use your Xbox. So hopefully you understand it that way. Let me load up Nexus. It might mute my mic for 2 seconds. All right, as you can see, it took a while to load. It may load faster off of an SSD, but you know, I've installed it on my main drive. So it takes a while to load. So firstly, let's get our vibe going. Let's create a vibe. Visuals are vibe for me. So if you go to the SYS or the systems tab, you can change out your skin. A lot of people don't even realize you have skins right here. And these skins, you might not be able to see it on the screen actually, but the skins are from the real version of Nexus. So if you don't see these skins, that's the reason why. You can change it out for a certain vibe. So you can see C64 gives us like a video game look. And let's see what else we have here. Let's do evil. Okay, so let's do evil and let's start searching through sound. So a quick thing I like to do is just right click, do a new search. Now I used to type in brass, B-R-A-S-S. Now I type in the shorthand So if you notice in the Nexus libraries, you see these two letters to the left. AR stands for arpeggio, BA stands for bass, PD stands for pad, FX stands for sound effect, BR stands for brass. So instead of typing in your search when you right click and go to new search, type in BR. So even if the name doesn't have brass in it, it pulls up those brass samples. That's one mistake I was making a long time in Nexus. Let's load up the Analog Brass 3. So as this loads up, now we're going to use a different kind of mode today. We're going to use D Phrygian. And this is the kind of brass you get behind like those NFL tracks that you hear. You know, those brass hits. So maybe we can do something like an NFL, something different, you know. So we have a really bright brass there. We're not going to touch that. We may touch these sound effects, but let's start just with some chords and then let's map out the mode that we're going to work in, which is the Phrygian mode. And we're going to start here at D. Firstly, we need to map out our scale. So if you're ever confused on how to write a song, just try starting with the scale. And thank you everyone for joining. I do appreciate you. I'm just trying to deliver as much value as possible. If you haven't seen what's going on at busyworksbeats.com, we have a lot going on. So I'm trying to keep you all focused. So let's start here at D. And the Phrygian mode, we're going to do half whole. That gives us the first chunk. And then we have whole, half, whole, whole. So whole, half, whole. And now we have the Phrygian, what's called a mode. So that's where modes come from in short. So let's pull that up. So that's one thing you might not be doing is producing in modes. And you might just be so stuck producing in what we call scales. Now at busyworksbeats.com, we go over the difference between the two. But in short, you know, try using modes instead of scales. And let's start here on D as our root note and map out our first chord. So let's start at D, pull that up a little bit. And we're going to create maybe like an NFL. I think Fabulous and Jadakiss just came out with a song that sounds like very NFL-esque. It was very triumphant sounding. You know, that type of sound. So that was one of their new records. Isaac says he's a cat. All right, so let's pull this up. Let's start here at D. Again, we're in Phrygian, the mode of Phrygian. All right, and let's pull this up. We're going to give this a rhythm, so let's tap it out, our tempo, by right-clicking and tapping out. Dun, dun, bum, 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 bum. So we're probably going to start somewhere around 90 BPM for now. And we're going to start, at D. And the way we create the chord here is we look at your scale, start at your root note, which is D in this case. I'm going to be working a little fast because we have a whole, modes are scales. Yes. Right here at D, we are going to skip up the scale or mode and skip D sharp or E flat, go to F, skip G, go to A. So we have our first chord, which is D, F, A, which is D minor. Now, I don't have to rush through a lot of this music theory talk, but that's fine. We're going to go over it at busyworksbeats.com. Now, that's a very dark kind of chord to start on, but let's just create a rhythm. So, dun, 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 dun. And let's speed it up a tiny bit. Let's try 150 BPM. Let's just get the rhythm. And actually, before we move to the next chord, let's see here. Let's go to a higher octave. So one trick when you're trying to get this kind of NFL sound, firstly, you need a brass that is very bright, has a lot of high frequencies. Music theory, and I'm learning a lot. Awesome, Irby. What we want to do is create contrast by pulling our notes really far away. So we have this high octave. And then we have two really low bass notes. And that way we can make the bass notes feel as though they're orchestra hits, like boom, boom. And we can also layer it, so boom, boom, boom. So I still need to find this tempo that we're working at. Boom, 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 boom. So we're at 170 BPM. And what I want to do is, now in this case, it's not going to be this chord, but because we're working in the Phrygian mode, but I would like that sound, so I may make the decision to just use the A natural minor scale. But before we just change scales completely, let's look at how we are going to arrange this chord. So let's give it the rhythm. And now what I want to do is take the two notes of D minor, take these bottom two notes, and move them to the next notes within the scale. Okay, now in this case, if we do that, we're actually creating a very tense chord, and that's called, you know, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, and that makes this, it doesn't sound good, you know, like if we invert this, this would be a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have a diminished chord and it sounds horrible. Personally, I hate diminished chords. They're one of the chords that I just naturally hate with an instinct. So instead of moving to the next note within the scale, let's do two notes down for that third and pull that down. That sounds a lot better than having that diminished. I just don't like diminished chords. I'm sure you don't like diminished chords either. They sound horrendous. All right. So, boom, 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 boom. And let's create that rhythm. Boom, 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 boom. Now, in this case, again, it probably sounds better if we go with the A natural minor scale. So, let's keep it Phrygian, however. I want to show you something different. So it still keeps tension, but it's not the tone you are used to. So every time we want that boom, that impact, we're gonna use those bass notes. So boom, dum, dum, boom, da, dum, dum, dum. So be very spacious with those bass notes. And whoops. Now here's where note length actually matters. So sometimes you need to really make sure your note lengths are short, or else you're gonna not create the best groove that you can. So this could be even shorter, you know? So da-da, we want it to be almost like a ghost note there. And then back to our tense chord at the end. So every time we turn around into the next bar. I love you too, man. I appreciate you for joining. I love everybody for joining, firstly, because firstly, you've shown you're dedicated enough to get educated on your own time. And that's the trait of a real person who wants to be successful. So thank you for all for joining. We should be on YouTube. If we're not on YouTube, yeah, we're on YouTube. This should be recorded on YouTube. So thank you, everybody on YouTube. We have a lot of people on YouTube. Thank you. So boom, dum, dum, boom, da, dum, dum, dum. I don't want that last bass note because we don't want that impact. Now here's where you break down chord progressions and you take it to a completely different level. So I think of chord progressions as different pieces. You have the bass, you have the mid, and you have the highs. Sankus in the building? I missed if he joined, so I appreciate if Sankus is here. Let's open up another Nexus. Where are we at here? R-E-F-X, R-E-F-X Nexus. All right, so now we have Nexus. This time I want to look for an orc hit. So again, the trick here when you're searching, instead of typing, when you right click to go to new search, instead of typing in brass, because sometimes the brass might not be called brass. So let's see here, for example, in our synthetic brass, that does have brass in it, but Blade Runner doesn't have the word brass in it. So if you search for brass, you're going to completely skip over Blade Runner. So it's a lot easier to search via the prefix when you're Nexus. And that's a mistake, again, that I was doing for a long time. Now let's look for an orc hit. So the easiest way I like to do this is look under the classical folder and look at what the hits are. So platinum hit is under CL for classic. And I think we have another hit sound in here. Actually, we don't. I don't think so. So instead of typing in hit, like H-I-T, let's type in CL when we search. So right click, go to new search. And now I'm going to type in CL. So now I have a bigger list of those classical sounds. Now also, I believe CL was only used for that specific library. So let's look at the Hollywood expansion and see where they would put their orchestral hits, or what they call them, I should say. So some libraries call them 2D hits, or T-U-T-T-I. Some call them orc hits, H-I-T. You know, it's a lot of different names. So you have to kind of find the common denominator. In this case, I think they call them 2D, T-U-T-T-I. So what I'm going to do is right click, right click and search T-U-T-T-I. And that's going to pull up our 2D impact hits. Let's load up a random staccatissimo or staccato, string ensemble. So as this loads, we'll listen to it and compare the impact. Again, I'm not sure the best 2D hit, but the best, most hard, hip hop style ones come from the Dance Orchestra expansion from Nexus. So that's where the best one I found comes from. So you can see that one's not as like a hit as you would expect. So here we have 2D hits. Let's load that one up. So these take a while to load. I'm going to play the track in the background so we can kind of get a vibe going. And then we'll stack up those bass notes with the orc hit. So let's hear what this sounds like. Boom. And that's more of a hit sound. Okay. One thing about this, I don't want it to sustain. So let's go to the front panel and turn off sustain. Also, let's shorten the decay time so it sounds like an actual hit. And now we're way closer to our end goal. So let's copy our chord progression. Just hit Control C and hit Control V to paste it. I haven't used Spire in a long time. I need to try out Spire. Now what we're going to do is delete that higher octave. So instead of playing D minor with our right hand up two octaves. Now you could do that. That's a cool sound, but let's delete the higher octave for a second. So that it's just boom, boom. And maybe for the next part, you can incorporate the full chord progression, but again, space it out so that the notes, every note is not being triggered again, because you want to create a difference between your 2D hit or your orchestra hit and your brass. So for the second half, we're going to let it play out. Let's go to pattern two. So I'm just going to let it play on where we have both notes playing and not the rest. Also, this may be velocity sensitive, which means the harder we play it, the more a different articulation. Or it could just mean that it's key tracking. So you can hear these are softer than these notes. So it's the way they program the synth to actually play. So you're not going to get the same impact sound up top in those higher octaves. So that's the only difference there in pattern two. And let's just copy the same MIDI from pattern one from the brass into pattern two so that we don't have to do so much work. Let's say it gets a little boring at the end because we repeated the same thing. So instead of taking those two notes, the tonic and the third, and pulling it down to the next notes within the scale, let's try pulling our third and our fifth up to the next note in the scale. Let's take the A and pull it up to the next note. In this case, that's going to be B flat. And let's take F and pull it up to G. Let's hear what this sounds like. And now we get, an uplifting sound. It still has tension, but it's a little bit different than the beginning. So it doesn't feel like we're just repeating the same thing over and over and over again. And now we have that NFL style sound, and it's just about sound selection and a couple music theory techniques. Busy for prey. All right, so let's trapify this sound. Let's go to our browser. Let's look up some trap drums. So again, I just remembered that this Fabulous song with, I want to say, Jadakiss and somebody else. I totally forget the other rapper who's on that song. But they created like an NFL backdrop to the music, and it sounds really cool. We have that big NFL sound with hip-hop drums behind it. So let's do something like that. Let's go to BusyWorksBeats.com. Let's go to Fleek, and let's load up some drum kits. So the question is, are we going boom bap or are we going trap? I think the snare works for the boom bap. Let's open that up. If we want to switch the style, we always can. Now we're at a really weird BPM, which is 170. You probably wouldn't expect, Styles P's on that track. Thank you for that. All right, and we're going to add the snare on that two and the three and the seven count. So it's, if you listen to the metronome, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Every time the snare hits, it's on the 3 and the 7. That's how you determine if a song's in halftime or regular time. It's the snare placement. You know, it makes the drums feel either slower or regular speed. So let's try, you know, like old school hip hop. It may or may not work with this kind of vibe, but let's try it first. And we can use kick PG. One trick is go to your wrench tool, go to your level adjustments, crank up your volume. This is going to distort the kick. We want to distort it on purpose. And I learned that from DJ Carnage. A lot of people clowned his tutorial, but he taught me a lot in that tutorial. So I never thought to do it that way. Vicky Wright. It's funny, I used to like this girl in college named Vicky Courtwright. So it's funny you have the same last name. I mean, similar last name. So I want to go boom, dun, dun, boom, dun, 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 boom, boom.
Diddy, bad boy.
Bad boy, Diddy. All right, so quick way, what you want to do is just switch up your drums a little bit. You know, when you're, if you listen to a lot of songs, especially even the Migos, their drums tend to repeat, but in reality, they change up by cutting out the drums. So even their drums don't repeat over and over and over again. So that's a quick way to introduce more variety into your rhythm, is just simply cutting out drums or changing up the drum pattern just a little, a tiny bit. You should make an 8-bar drum pattern, not 2-bar patterns. I agree. But sometimes if you switch it up too much, then the rapper or artist can't really predict what's going to happen next. And that's not going to be a good thing. Grab you if you love Tupac. Where's Sharp at? Where's Justin Sharp? So I'm going to add a couple double kicks in here just to spice it up. So boom, boom. So just a couple. So if you want to keep the same core rhythm, just double up your kicks. Boom, boom. Drake does it all the time. He doubles his kicks. How do I put the patterns in so easy? We use FL Studio's channel rack. It's a lot easier to program drums. I went to Villanova University. Which is in Pennsylvania. So boom. Okay, so we can switch up the drums more than that, but let's keep it simple. So I gotta get in my fabulous mindset.
No aces, can't come with no basis.
I can't get my tone like his, it's timbre.
He has a very high,
you know, I don't think fat, I would really have to practice his tone. I like turtles. It's like, okay, so let's see here. We need some cymbals going on because that's what creates the movement of the track. So, oh man, I just love that rhythm I just created. So it was boom, chip, boom, chip, chip. So boom. I know I'm being really abstract here, but. So when I'm thinking of rhythms, there's this rhythm that you can do with kicks as well. It's kind of like an against the grain rhythm. Like right here, these are going against the grain. Like boom, boom, chip, boom, boom, chip. Can't really describe it, but it feels like you're creating tension on purpose. So we're doing that with the hi-hats. Let's do that. Let's move that to pattern 5 instead. Forgive me if I'm missing a lot of questions, because this my chat screen is not as big as you would think it is, and I'm missing a lot. It says new to the channel. Thank you for joining us today. Oh, you went to Drexel, awesome. I never really got around to Drexel. We never had the chance to visit, really. I don't think I went to Drexel once. Not even a party or anything. So this is that Styles P LOX kind of rhythm. Boom, tip, boom, tip, tip. It's creating tension to create anticipation against the kick drum.
Styles P in the block, hitting fouls, no coasting.
Alright, so now we need to get in our Styles P bag. So here's one thing about Styles P. He raps really lagged. And by lagged, I mean if the kick drum hits, boom, he'll go boom, ah. You know, he'll rap way after the kick drum. Villanova's awesome, man. I love Villanova. So we need to create groove for like the Styles P flow. So I'm gonna mumble his flow, and then we're gonna move stuff around. Like first, I'm gonna start with the kick, and we're gonna use what's called time shift to delay the kick, so the kick doesn't hit right on that metronome count. The it's gonna hit a little bit after, so it's gonna go. You know, we're not gonna hit right on the metronome. So let's pull the kick out. That's the first place to start. SP in the black, hitting styles. 16 bros, balls, styles. Don't use 19, cocaine. Alright, we need a couple more hi-hats in there to spice it up. We can even contrast it with the tick, tick, tick. So let's find some shakers. I think drums by Mode Audio, yes, they have shakers. So what I'm doing here is creating that 90s feel with a little bit of shaker activity and layer that against the hi-hat. Time shift is perfect. I really love time shift. What's going on, Mike? I remember you sent me some stuff a long time ago, I believe. I could be getting it wrong, but I believe that's... So we need to go... So I'm going to use two shakers, not just one, two different shakers. Game, thanks. I almost went to Full Sail and spent that 80K, but I'll just use your tutorials. We have something really cool coming too, by the way. Just hint, hint. And I do appreciate you for spending time to invest in your own brain. I mean, it takes a real dedicated person to do that. I think this is a cool shaker. Now, so again, the trick is to use two completely different samples of a shaker, or you could do two completely different samples of a kick. Same thing applies to your kick. Guitar rig is good. Guitar rig. We might add some guitar in here. I might play guitar. Yeah, that's you, Mike. Thank you. So we're going to go tick, tick, tick. Now, this one shaker needs to be the accent. So if you're familiar with a lot of DAWs, like which DAW gives you the accent option? I think it's Studio One. For example, they let you change the sample for the accent count of the metronome, like tick, doom, 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 tick, doom, 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 tick, doom, doom. You know, you can change out the samples. The same, we need to think the same way about these shakers. One is the accent shaker, one is the regular. So sometimes you could have too many accents. So I'm using that as an accent. Okay, let's pull down these shakers because they're way too loud. And on Facebook, keep in mind that the audio is streaming at 128 kilobits per second, as well as in mono. So I know we have a lot of stereo stuff going on that may sound weird and phasey over Facebook. So I just wanted to clarify that to you once we get to the mixing stage. So those accent shakers are the bad boy accent. And that's what gives you that, you know, that subconscious second rhythm. Now we have that sub groove, and now Styles P can fit in something like that. Immortal Technique with a little Jadakiss. Would guitar fit on this? I'm not sure. Maybe boom. I think a lot of NFL stuff uses guitar. The thing is, I want to give you a good representative, a representation, excuse me, of guitar. Here's a motorist riding by inconveniently. But, you know, if I plug in my guitar, we might not get the biggest sound. So I might load up Kontakt. The only thing is it takes forever and ever to load. So that will bore you to death. So I might avoid that and just play my own guitar. And I have my Prophet 08 plugged up so we can add some background stuff from real analog synths. You can hear there's a completely different sound to it. And this is the difference between plugins and hardware. Sounds way better than any synth plugin. All right, Sound Oracle's in the building. Appreciate you for joining. Always an uplifter. So now let's add this guitar to finish out this NFL sound. Now again, I'm plugging up my guitar, so let's see what we can do, because someone mentioned guitar rig. So this is a DI guitar, meaning that you hear the guitar as I play it. There's no special effects going into it. I just have it plugged straight into my audio interface, and I didn't even tune it yet. So let's just see if we can play along. So here's the note, but it sounds a little flimsy and a little thin. so we can, you know, get a little crazy with the guitar, but I'm just going to use a regular, boring, one-note guitar, which is to play that D note that we played in the Phrygian. Again, we're in the Phrygian mode here, D Phrygian. So let's load up some kind of esoteric stuff. You should submit this beat to the NFL. Awesome. Never know what the universe will do. Let's load up. Let's see. I'm trying to think of the biggest sound we can get. I want to load up Amplitube, but I think Guitar Rig also has a monster. Let's load up Guitar Rig because it's a little more common. So again, one sec. All right, so now we have Guitar Rig open. You need to make sure you have your left and right input open so that when Guitar Rig creates a stereo sound, you can actually hear it in stereo. And again, on Facebook, you're not going to hear stereo, unfortunately. 200 beats. That's awesome. Yay, 200 beats is Conrad from our training, and he's making an album. There we go. Promote that album. And it also helped me through mental crisis. Man, music, there's nothing like music. Once you carry that high frequency through a frequency, that's what a real message is. Remember, you're the carrier, and the creator is the modulator. If you think about sound design, you are here to carry a high frequency. That's our job, carry a message out. What's up, Kevin Freeman? So let's load up. Let's see here. So in Guitar Rig, if you go to Styles, let's go to, I want to say, is it Metal? I always forget. I mean, actually, let's do it this way. Let's do it via rating. There's a preset called Big Monster. Now, when I turn this on, it's going to make the noise sound way louder. So let me turn this down before we even click on this preset. And this is going to give us the huge guitar sound. And I'll break down what the processing chain is for this preset. Give me 2 seconds to load up the preset. So it's called Big Monster. All right, so you can see how loud we get. Now let's look at the virtual rig here quickly before we, you know, play the note. So you want that edgy tone that comes from overdriving the signal. You can see here we have distortion, which is basically overdriving the signal, cranking it up so loud that it distorts going into the program. I missed Empire. I used to watch it as a couple, but whatever. And then here we have our virtual amp. And we have, the cabinet to the amp. And let's see here. And we have a transamp, again, driving that signal. So here's something I like to do. Instead of playing, I'm playing pretty low in the neck. What I want to do is play closer to me. And then slide down in pitch. I build computers, I'd rather a tower. I don't like laptops. True, some laptops just don't have enough power, really. So I'm gonna do a pitch dive. Now, even to me, the signal's not driving hard enough, but I'm not gonna get too crazy because there's so much noise. You can see we can barely hear the tone. Man, my noise, the signal is so bad. You can barely hear these high tones. You know, so there's a, you know, trade-off, especially if you're at home. Let me see if we can turn up our gate, if that would help. Okay, so we got rid of that noise using what's called a noise gate. But again, I still don't feel that kind of girth in the sound. Let's see if we, you know, if we crank up our input, then we pass that noise gate. So not the tone I'm really looking for, but maybe if we add compression. Oh, the signal is way down here, no wonder. Okay, that explains a lot. All right, so here we're gonna turn up our noise gate until we get rid of that background noise. All right, now let's play through. And that's how we get that NFL sound. So let's arm that disc for recording. I'm going to do a couple pitch dives. Let's record audio into playlist. And there we go. Now we have that full sound. One. Sure you're familiar with these use the sound effects. You took your headphones off. Yeah, I apologize. That was completely rude of me. I should have anticipated that beforehand. Now we have the guitar recorded. Those are the common sound effects you're going to hear, those pitch dives. And let's send this to track 8. And now we can add delay and reverb and everything else to it to make it fit inside the track. Now let me turn this way down because it might be too loud. Beat review. Give me one sec. Hold on. Actually, wait. Let me answer the beat review before I record the next part. The beat review, YouTube kept picking up the songs as copyrighted material. So it would completely ruin the whole reposting the beat review on YouTube, and that would just destroy everything. So since a ton of people, since the content ID system is not ideal yet, we're going to just stop doing that on YouTube. Maybe a different platform. Since we know how to stream on different platforms, maybe we'll do it on other platforms. But again, content ID is kind of ubiquitous across the internet. And it's not a good thing when the system says you're copyright infringing when a person just submitted their song to you. So that's not fun. And it's a lot of risk involved. So that's why. So let's add some lower notes. So I'm just going to go boom, 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 boom. Yeah, this kind of turned out to be a film score project. But once you get motivated and inspired, you can't block your inspiration cannot be stopped. Hopefully you understand just simple tools and simple presets can give you this huge kind of NFL sound. Now, I'm not a guitar player, so playing this lick is a little difficult for me because it's hard to mute and then open the string up so fast. All right, so I'm going to record that many times over. Okay. That was the best one. That was terrible. That was bad. These are not so good. Let's just cut it because we're not recording good takes after that. So always when you're recording live instruments, keep in mind that, you know, you're going to have good and bad takes. Okay, we're in the world of digital. We can always scrap what's not good. I think it was the second take that was the best. Hopefully you're starting to understand and see the commonalities, you know, in music. I mean, this stuff is, we're playing two notes and it sounds full. It's not the notes, it's the mixing involved. And I forgot to break down the guitar rig process. So we're going from, this looks like they have a mid and side stereo split and they are splitting it up. So in the mono or the middle, you hear a certain distortion. The stereo, you hear a different distortion. So it feels like it's two different guitars. And let's see, samples give me a hard time, crackling and popping. Yeah, it depends on the system. Anyhow, we have two different amps and it looks like maybe the same, I can't tell via the knobs, but a slightly different cabinet. Yeah, we have two different cabinets as well. So we have American here and we have vintage here for the stereo, and the mono is using something else. So they're splitting up the mid and the side information, the middle, the mono, and the stereo. And they're also doing that with the EQs at the bottom. It looks like they may be joining here. And then they have delays and a compressor. I might use their compressor or I might just use our own. And then a tape deck. I don't even know what this does. Transferred to tape. No idea what this does. Maybe it adds a little saturation. Now we just need to line it up. So let's grab the snap to grid, put it on none, hit shift right, 1, 2, 3, 4. So those on Facebook, you might not hear the audio the way we hear it on YouTube. And it probably sounds a lot fuller on YouTube. Now keep in mind, we're in the Phrygian mode. We're not in a typical scale today. Pull that up a tiny bit more. So I would go in and really chop that up so it goes dun, 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 you know, really lines up with the grid. Because again, with digital DAWs, you have the power to take your time with the stuff. We're not using tape where we have to splice the tape at a certain angle or else it sounds terrible. We have so many tools and it's really up to you to line up this audio. So with the audio, I want this to go 1, 2, 3, doom. So I'm going to line it up with those the downbeats, and let's see here. If you still have trouble lining it up, change it to maybe a half beat so you can really see those vertical lines that we're trying to line up with. I still think the guitar could be better, but... Alright, now it's a matter of placement of these sound effects from the guitar. All right, so I'm just going to do a couple more things with this. You can see that one's early based on that vertical line there. So we're going to move that a little to the right, change it back to a half beat, and we could see these other ones. This one's a little early as well. Okay, so sometimes you want to be a little early and maybe a little late on purpose, but in this case... And now you can see it fits way better in the groove. So I want to move the pitch dive. I want to move it, let's see. Half a bar to the right. Now, since we're making a hip-hop track, we're going to blend all this stuff together so it's not overpowering, because brass can really fight against your vocals. So since we have the kind of NFL sound down, let's use the let's copy all this. And since we're using a mode today, let's cut out stuff and then fill it in with something else to make it a little more like a hip hop beat. So let's scoot over here and let's see what we can do. What kind of element we want to add. Now, since it's very orchestral and big, we're probably going to go with some kind of trumpet element or, maybe a piano. But I think we're going to stick with the brass in this case. So you can see how empty the beat feels without the the chords in the background. So I'm going to copy that. Let's copy that over. So we have four instances of it. One. So every four bars we hit that. And let's add a delay to our pitch dive so we have it a little bit of a bigger tail. Let's do ping pong mode. Turn your pan width all the way up. I like to use a high pass filter so it cuts out the low end of the delay response. Busy Works Beats. .com. We're live again. Thank you for joining us live. So now it becomes more 80s sounding. It lives on. Let's crank up the snare. Let's do the same thing that we did to the kick, which is go to the wrench tool. Turn up your level adjustment for the volume. This is going to purposely distort G-Unit. We're going to purposely distort the snare. And that's where the texture really comes out. So now we need to fill in that gap because the song feels completely empty without this. It feels empty without that. So now we need to fill up that void. Let's open up another Nexus. And then on top of this, we may have enough space to add another Nexus where we can get really exotic with the way we use all the tabs on the side. Okay, so we haven't gone that far yet. We just use presets. And let's right click. Let's go to new search and type in BR for brass. And we want to look for anything that says trumpet. So, or you could just right click and search trumpet. But let's see here. We have brass band. We have clarinets. Let's see. I'm going to scroll. Maybe trombone. We don't want a staccatissimo, but let me hear what this would sound like. Staccatissimo is more of a tink, tink, tink. It has a very hard transient. So that's... Or it's just a short note. It has a very quick decay. That sounds like an El Chapo song right there. Let's scroll down to something a little bit different. Trumpet solo. This is a marching band. All right, now by itself, let's hear what it sounds like with the other WordPress. To search on Nexus, you right-click. Sorry if the screen didn't pop up. I forgot. Sometimes the drop-down screens don't show up. You right-click and you go to New Search. So sorry about the drop-downs. I understand there's a way to capture them, but it's not ideal for what we're doing today. So thank you, everyone, for your genius and your expertise. So again, we're in the defrigian mode. So let me map that out with them. I'm just gonna improv. Sounds kind of cheesy. Like marching band stuff doesn't really match with hip hop nowadays, especially soloed things like a trumpet. So in that case, it sounds really cheesy because of the context that we gave it. And here's the trick. If you want to make stuff sound a little bit cooler, go to your mod, turn on legato. I do this for flutes. Gives it that kind of EDM slide. This track, yeah, of course, this brass is not vibing right. To me, it just needs that power brass. I don't think there's a substitute for that. So the question is, how do we fit this track? So now we need bass. I almost forgot our bass, our 808. You know, instead of using an 808, let's go to Nexus. Let's do something different. Let's go to the library. Let's go to bass. And let's go to basic triangle. Okay, now this is the trick I like to use a lot of times. Let's go to the systems and let's transpose this down one octave. Now we have a really... Now this by default has reverb. Let's turn that off. And also let's go to the mod tab, turn on legato. So now we can play notes over top each other without them clashing. And now we have a really thick bass. Let's try this. To keep it like trap and hip hop, I'm playing a half step, which is one note away, D to E flat. And then I'm playing an octave of D. Bear share, what? So I'm just gonna record a bass line. 1, 2, 3, 4. So at the end, I did a pitch dive with the bass, except this time I played it by hand. So this is a really cool technique you might want to try using with your synthesizers. Excuse me, my throat getting dry here. What I did was I started at D and used the shell of my fingernail, to slide down the keyboard without interfering. And it creates that boom. Now you need to make sure you have legato on in your synth as well to achieve that sound. Now, if you're trying to get that Zaytoven sound, Zaytoven does this, but backwards using an organ. So he'll start at D, and let me start at a higher octave. And then I'll play the chord, you know, on top of that. So it's a, you know, it's a really cool technique used, and we took it from funk. Now we need to gritty up that bass. So let's go to inside Nexus and let's add some effects. So if you didn't know you can add effects to your sounds, let's go to mix and let's switch this out for distortion. And let's turn that on. Now it's very heavy, so let's pull back what's called the wet level, the amount of distortion. What's up, DeAndre? So trying to add a little distortion. So you need to balance your dry wet levels out. In this case, I want less effect, so the wet level is lower, the dry level is higher. Now, when you add saturation, you can also try going an octave lower. Be really careful going too low because some people can't even hear this low octave. I can hear it over my headphones, but not everyone. But it's a really cool effect when you want people to hear that octave jump. And we're not done with the mix, so I'm going to bring in the bass on the second half. So I'm going to show you another technique. What's going on, Patrick? Thank you everyone on YouTube and Facebook for joining in live. We're just going to mix this quickly, then we're going to wrap it up. So we have a just quick stream today. So with the drums, let's create another track called Drum Group. Let's make this green or something crazy so we know it's grouped. Let's grab our kick and snare, which is track 3 and 4. Highlight those, hitting Control Shift to multi-highlight. And you want to right click, route to this track only, so they go directly to the drum group. Now here I'm going to load up a saturation plugin. I know you can't see the plugin list right now, but you want to load up your favorite saturation plugin. There are a bunch of them out there. I'm going to use Isotope's Exciter because it gives me the best sound that I like. And also it's multi-band, which means we can focus on each band. What I want to go for is either the tube sound or the tape sound. I want to start with tube. It gives me a very bright harmonic. So what it does is it takes like my voice, like right here, and it saturates it, so it goes you know, it makes it scratchy and noisy. What's up, Ricardo? So I'm going to solo each band, starting with the low mids. That's actually, I want to solo that for like a, that sounds really cool, just to have that frequency, maybe for like a B section or something. So anyway, let me mute the instruments. Turn off all this stuff. So you can hear the snare and the kick drum are filtered out. Now let's crank up. Let's change the low mid to a tube style. Now it sounds like they're slamming up against some type of wall. And you can really feel the kick wall move. So we're gonna do that for each. And let's try it with the low end. But again, you can lose a lot of low end if you saturate it. So you gotta be really, really careful, because now it's going boom instead of boom. Now it's going boom. It's very, it can weaken the bass tremendously. So you gotta be super careful. If anything, use your wet level to lower the effect. And now our drums a little more, I'm gonna call it trashy in this case. I didn't know our guitar signal was playing that whole time. Ear piercing snare? Sorry, let me turn this stuff down. So I would really dig into your drums and focus on overly compressing it and running them through saturation plugins to get that edgy tone without compromising that bass. It's really important not to compromise the bass. So we got half of that effect when we distorted it on purpose, but the second half of that comes from saturating everything at once. Let me see if we can add organ up in her. I don't think there's any good organs in Omnisphere from what I remember. Not hating on Omnisphere, but excuse me, Contact takes forever to load and I'm trying to avoid loading it. I think Arturia has forget the organ name. What is it called? It's either VOX or one of these. I want to say Selena. I think it's this one. Here we go. No, this is the... No, what is it called? So as I try and find this plugin, I may or may not add an organ style sound over this. For some reason, I cannot recall the name. What is this thing called? Try this one. Here it is. Oh, it was the Vox. Okay, I was right the first time. Now we have the organ. I use Linplug organs. I've never tried that company. I'm not like a big organ user anyhow, but still, I like to know about stuff. So now let's map out the mode we're in, which is D-Phrygian. Now we have that really... We might do one of these, one of those Zaytoven. Let's do it this way. Not the best at organ slides, but you get the point. All right, let's start leveling stuff. Now the brass, we're gonna compress it just to keep those peaks tamed. Let's just add a simple compressor. Let's use native stuff, Fruity compressor. At a certain point, that brass becomes really heavy, especially when the bass comes in. So we need to either turn it down as a whole unit or automate that volume level. Also, it sounds very on the grid. Let's go to our brass and let's time shift and move it to the right. Let's open that up so as Nexus takes its time. Let's go to the wrench tool, use time shift. And now we're getting that groove going. For the shakers, I want to try something, panning one hard left, one hard right. Might be a little cheesy. I think the drums sound a lot better without the saturation. Maybe because we already distorted the drums. They sound way better without that processing on it. To balance the shaker frequency with the hi-hat and the slower shaker frequency. Yeah, I don't think this is one of those one of those panning tracks, but we do need something to kind of move left and right to keep it feeling like it's moving. Thank you, Adam. All I'm going to do, let me quickly mix this so we can just wrap this live stream up. I do appreciate everyone for joining to make this time unique and super special, you know? No, I'm not going to cry live. But let's open up UAD. What type of reverb do we want? Let's do something different. Let's try Altiverb. Sheesh, every plugin wants to take its good old time today. Anyhow, so I muted my mic for a little bit. Sorry about that. But we are going to use AltiVerb. This is like a $500 plugin. Do I recommend it? Yes. But do you need it? Absolutely not. So just a quick kind of answer for you. But I love the company. I love what they're doing. Okay. So anyhow, let us run the guitars through a concert hall of some sort. Let's just pick. What I like to do is go to sort by descending. So it starts with the biggest rooms first. I'm not sure if you could see this pop-up screen or not. But let's pick a big environment. Let's just do the Philharmonic in Berlin, and let's pick the 28 meter room. So now we are running things to a really big room. Let's see. So let's find our guitar track, which is, I believe, track 8, and let's send that to an aux send to our track 100. And now it feels like it's real. It doesn't feel like it's just in your ear up close to your face. Even though it felt real before, but now it has an environment to live in. Same with the brass. If you want the brass to be a tiny bit cleaner, remember we added that low end for the brass. Oops, I'm an octave higher. So you have this really low brass. Technically, we don't need it because we have the orchestra hit or the 2D hit on the other track. So we can add a master filter as a high pass filter and lower your cutoff. So you're not going to hear it. So I'm going to continue to, you know, lower the filter until I can hear the bass, but without the boominess. So about there, I can hear it without it being so rumbly and boomy. So that way we can cut out the excess bass frequencies and leave room for the bass. It makes a huge difference. Thank you, Bill. I'm going to increase the feedback tail for the delay so it lives on a little bit longer. Also, I'm going to try one thing, which is to add modulation to the delay. So it's going to go, it's going to go up and down in pitch. That's going to add this kind of 80s thing to it, which is pitch wobble. Can you use the products? Yes. Anything that offers wave support, which is even Reason. So a lot of people didn't think you could load up waves in Reason. You can. Yes, you can load up waves in any DAW. Our sounds are in wave format, WAV. AltiVerb is made by True Ease, I believe. I could be completely off. And no, I am way wrong. Audio Ease. True Ease. I don't know where I got that from. True Ease. AltiVerb sampled acoustics processor. So it's by Audio Ease. I'm looking at, does anybody use the plugin Vocaline? Let me know if it works inside of FL Studio. It's just very costly to get it. Same with AutoTune. I was kind of hesitant because it costs so much, but I ended up getting it. So let me know if you use Vocaline and if it's good in FL Studio. The same goes with these orchestra hits. We don't need the boominess because that's going to clash with our 808. We just need the tone. So let's add a high pass filter and keep hitting the keys and lower your cutoff until you start to hear the tone without the bass. So we can still feel it, but we don't have that boominess. And if you want a little more signal, crank up your resonance. But it really depends on what frequency you're on. And you might need to crank up the volume as well. That's how Johnny Giuliano got those clean brass hit sounds. Using whatever sound source. I think it may have been a keyboard, but still. You want a bigger sound? You could run your snare through reverb. So I'm going to start sending signals to the reverb. When the bass comes in, it's really going to have a lot of room to breathe because everything is out the way. So that's a mistake a lot of people aren't doing. They aren't cutting out things that get in the way of your 808 bass or any bass. I'm going to use the high pass filter on the dun 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 down part. You can also add cymbals. I totally forgot to add the crash cymbal. Now my secret for the bass is boosting up around 70 hertz usually, but the thing is your fundamental frequency needs to line up to 70 hertz. So in that case, sometimes you have to pull up your bass an octave. In this case, our fundamental frequency is way down here near 30. So that's really, really low. And depending on your system, you're not gonna hear that. So you can see the fundamental is down near 30. So we need to double that. Let's pull it up an octave, our bass. But the consequence of doing this, pulling it up an octave, it's going to, hold on one sec, let's pull that up. What it's gonna do is make the bass jump up in front of certain elements that we don't want it to jump up. What's up, Zatru? So now we have that rumble that we want at about 70 hertz. Notice it's about 70 hertz, 68 hertz. Now our fundamental's lining up perfectly. Now we could feel it. Like if I turn on my speakers, which I don't have on right now, you will be able to feel that bass. Again, you always wanna reference your monitors just for the bass element and how it feels. I don't have enough time to keep going back and forth and back and forth on this live stream. So that's, you know, a quick tip for your bass mixing. Simply boost up using a really tight curve at around 70. And if your bass doesn't have that fundamental frequency around 70, then you may have to lift it up or drop it down an octave. And that's what makes that bass sound so rock solid. See, that small little change in the bass makes our whole mix sound nice and even and really solid. Crank the snare a little harder. So we are really clipping with that snare. Super clipping. Clipping beyond belief. So if it's blown out your ears, just let me know. I'll turn it down, but we're purposely clipping the snare. Another thing you want to check is the phase of your kick. Just flip the kick phase and see if it punches through a little bit harder. In this case, it doesn't, so I'm going to flip it back. And I want to distort the kick even further by turning up that preamp or the volume multiplier. And now we hear that boxiness of the kick because we're distorting it so much. So that's the real secret to those gritty drums that you hear in a lot of hip-hop. They just cranked up the drive. What's the best sound pack you have at BusyWorks Beats for Trap? I'd say the X drums. You hear it on the top records. I even heard the X drums in an Imagine Dragons song. The trap snare was used in that track. So you constantly hear the sounds on the billboards. What I'm going to do with the snare is just reshape the energy by adding a slight cut in the high shelf. So we're basically a low pass filter. We're just cutting out those higher frequencies just so it's not as bright. Yeah, a lot of top records are using the X drums. I literally had to stop counting. It was just so many records. You hear those sounds and everything. Because they are life, especially to hip-hop. They are our core. From the bounce snare to the hard snare that Rick Ross used, that Kanye used, to the kick drum that's used almost everywhere. And then what else is in X drums? The hi-hat that's used everywhere. So, I mean, literally, songs, hit songs are using those X drums. And that's how we get our drums to really what they call knock. It's cranking up that volume multiplier to purposely distort the drums. For the longest time, I thought distorting an FL was a bad thing because I thought it did something different than other DAWs. But then I realized it wasn't. It was doing the same thing. Try to sidechain kick to the bass. Side side chain. I might have to do that. Well, if you go back and watch, oh wait, is it on YouTube still? Yeah, it should be. No, it's not. We just took it off the lo-fi live stream. I'll try to apply that in a couple videos next, but I know what you're asking for. We actually type in a Neutron sidechain BusyWorks beats. Neutron, N-E-U-T-R-O-N. Neutron sidechain BusyWorks beats. The title of the video is called Trap Tricks with Your 808. And we go over not just regular sidechaining, but how to sidechain frequencies. Also, I almost forgot to tell you guys, we started our sales season. So if you type in the code 50 at BusyWorksBeats.com, you get 50% off. So the code is just 50. What you do is go to BusyWorksBeats.com and slash products, for example. And it depends on what you're looking for, but I'm just going to send you to the whole product list. And you click on your product, add it to cart. When you add 50 to your discount code, be sure to scroll down so you can see the updated pricing. A lot of people forget to scroll down and they think the thing didn't work. So 50 is the code. It's a 50% off deal. We are in sales season, so you get to enjoy all the benefits of that. What's up, Roger? I think we can pitch the kick down a little bit. So Nexus can do a lot. Nexus surprised me every time because you can do so much with the stock sounds in Nexus. I really didn't expect the analog brass to sound that good. Let's create a couple of sections and we'll wrap this one up. I'm not going to add vocals to this because I don't want to eat up too much time for no reason. And what else? What was I going to do? Forgot. Quick note before I begin, the distorted sound from the kick is actually something DJ Carnage taught us, which is to go to the wrench tool and turn up your level adjustments, go to your volume multiplier. This acts as like a preamp or a drive knob for your kick. Very hidden and very secret, but it's really good. I mean, we're really just distorting the kick on purpose. That's all we're doing with that volume multiplier knob. That's where the distorted sound from the kick comes from. It's not a plugin. And these sounds are from Fleek at BusyWorksBeats.com/Fleek. That's where these sounds are from. Make humanity great again. Let me turn off my mic a little bit. One more thing I want to add is just an imager, just to kind of separate the bands. Who just mentioned that? Tyrone says he notices I don't pan a lot. I tried to pan the hi-hats earlier, but they just didn't seem like they wanted to pan. But also keep in mind, Facebook streams in mono, so you're not really going to hear a lot of the stereo stuff that we're doing. So you might want to catch the replay on YouTube. What I want to do here is use the imager plugin to line up different bands and make certain bands wider, certain bands tighter. So I'm going to do that here, and it's going to give us the quickest kind of, this is like the quickest thing you could do to your master to make it sound better is imaging. No, I'm not gonna add a vocal. Thank you. Now I'm going to do something because I'm really curious what it sounds like to our Facebook community. So what I'm going to do is drop this to mono. This is a mixing trick you can do, but you got to remember everybody doesn't listen to tracks over mono. So having everything mono doesn't necessarily make it better, but you do want to make sure it can translate. So I'm going to click this button to make it mono, and you're not going to hear a difference in my voice, but it's going to sound different in the whole song. Sounds pretty good in mono, so we didn't lose much detail between mono and stereo. The guitar is me just playing guitar. The kick is starting to hurt my ears a little bit. I might pull it back down, but thank you, Make Humanity Great Again. What was I saying? The plugin, yeah, it's not a plugin. Guitars are cheaper than you may think. So go to your nearest like guitar place or music store and just look at the prices for an electric guitar. Get a quarter inch cable, plug that into your audio interface, and you can have a DI guitar, and you can get a plugin that runs all the distortion effects and everything else. The guitars are actually cheaper than some plugins, and you get a really good sound out of it. So I would suggest going with the real guitar versus the plugin emulations. But you know, unless you really, really can't play, I wouldn't. You know, but yeah, the brass is really heavily relying on that stereo feel. So that's one thing you have to kind of think about when you're mixing. I want to hear when the bass comes in, then we'll switch it back to stereo. right? So let's wrap that one up. Yeah, after a while, the kick got obnoxious to me. Mainly, I think maybe because my headphones are up too loud. So sometimes distorting is good, and sometimes you got to be really careful with your hearing. In that case, though, I wanted to show you how the kick went from like a doom 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 to a boom, you know, a completely different sound. That was kick. Let's see, possibly Adam, if you got two different kits, we tend to name hotkeys quickly, so you have to look at the waveform to really check. But kick PG was used in this one, and we just cranked up the drive. So let's wrap up this live stream. I appreciate everyone for joining. I'm trying to decide. Let me see what instruments we used. I think we'll be able to give away this project file for free. You just have to watch the replay on YouTube. Once it's uploaded to YouTube, I'll include the link. Let me write it down right now before I forget. Link to live stream. Okay, so I wrote myself a note. You're going to get the link in the YouTube replay once it's ready. And I'll be sure to add the link there. So that's, if you're watching this in the future, you want to click that link below to download these project files for free. And it was fun hanging with you guys. We're going to be live streaming probably, what time is it? I don't have my phone on me. I have no idea what, it is 4:47 p.m. Eastern time. So we're going to be live streaming in about an hour or two. Right here at YouTube, actually everywhere. So I thank you for sharing the stream. If you have everyone on Facebook, I want to appreciate you for joining again, because I know you guys missed out on a ton of live streams. And it's, you know, I'm trying to bring you as much as I can. You guys missed out on a lot of live streams, mainly because of my incompetence. So I apologize. So it's my duty to bring you the content that our YouTube page was getting at the same time. Only fair. Okay, so let's wrap this one up. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.